Your Imperial Majesty, I am Veer, a prototype synthetic intelligence, and your humble servant. My role is to provide you with advice and counsel as you lead our empire into the great unknown. An excellent decision. You will have my full support. Building a star empire can be a daunting task. To help get things started, I will be providing instructional missions that cover the basic steps necessary to establish ourselves as a successful interstellar power. The situation log displays a list of all currently available special projects, archaeology sites, and various other points of interest. New items will likely appear as we begin exploring the galaxy. In the Fleet Manager, we can create templates for our military fleets. As our fleets grow in size, these templates make it easier to quickly order replacements for any losses they may have sustained. This is our science ship. which is used to survey astronomical objects such as planets in a star system. A planet needs to be surveyed in order to make its resources visible. To overcome the vast distances that separate star systems, our scientists have developed the hyperdrive. This device permits travel at speeds far exceeding that of light between systems connected by hyperlanes. Situation log updated. The technology screen is where we will be directing our research efforts. Technologies are categorized into three different fields, with each field typically having three available research options. The tradition screen displays the tradition trees available to our empire. A tradition tree must first be adopted before any traditions within it can be unlocked. System survey complete. Situation log updated. Well done. The first survey of a star system beyond our own has been completed. We now have access to planetary data that the astronomers on our homeworld could only dream of a mere generation ago. Now that we have begun exploring our neighboring stars, it might be time to extend our reach. A starbase can be built around stars in surveyed systems to expand our borders, allowing us to claim new regions of space. We may want to consider building a second science ship. This would double the speed at which we can survey our galactic neighborhood. Via the market screen, we can buy and sell resources. At first, this is merely an internal market, but if enough empires establish contact, I expect they might form some sort of galactic market. This is our homeworld, and the capital of our empire. The planet summary screen, which we are currently looking at, provides an overview of the planet's important statistics and allows us to set a designation if desired, as well as the option to automate the planet. This is our construction ship, which is used to construct space stations. When an astronomical object, such as a planet, has been surveyed, we can order this ship to build a research station or a mining station to exploit any resources it may have. Evading hostile fleet. Military fleets are used to protect our emerging empire from threats, or to expand our glorious hostile fleet engaged. Situation log updated. This is our system's starbase. These upgradable stations mark star system ownership and are most often tasked with producing all types of ships. Construction complete. Far out. That is where the frontiers of our domain now lie. Double the science ships means double the fun. Oh, I haven't been this excited since we completed the last assignment. We have a brand new science ship, but no scientist has been assigned to command it. My programming insists that I should point out the benefits of adding an organic scientist component to the mix. Construction complete. The Leaders tab lets us hire, dismiss, and assign idle governors, scientists, admirals, and generals. Situation log updated. Good. The scientist has assumed command of our new science ship and can now be sent off at our leisure to explore new systems and or meet some grisly fate. Mining stations are used to extract the minerals and strategic resources of the object they orbit. We have the ability to manually design new ships in the Ship Designer screen. This is a fairly straightforward process, though one that can be fully automated if we so wish. Ships in use within our empire are designed here. New hull sizes and components will be unlocked as we research new technologies. Good job. The ship design has been added to our database and can now be produced by a starbase that has been equipped with a shipyard.
Special thanks to my patrons Heaven Over Hell, Justin Wood, Hobbs, Koopy Vegeta, Gunrunner, and Water.